will definitely be missed.
Next, she's currently waking us up in the morning with her Radio Nova breakfast show, and I caught up with Lucy Kennedy to talk about her latest collaboration.
Lucy, the empowerment pendant. It's absolutely beautiful. Tell me about it.
Okay, this was created by Juby Designs. It's €95. It's sold in Arnott's and online. All proceeds go straight to the ISPCC, so I'm very proud to be working on this campaign.
And for more information, check out JubyDesigns.com. Time now to check back in with Cassie, who's with stylist Rob Condon. Cass.
Yes, Linda, I'm here in the can of Ireland. Sorry that you have to be in studio. We're just here in Dalkey. I'm joined by Rob Condon, the stylist, who has picked out some summer essentials for us for this amazing weather.
You're telling me I am not on trend because I'm wearing pajamas.
Myself and Rob are just going to stay out here in the sun, top up my freckles, he's going to top up his tan. Linda, it's back to you in studio.
Cheers, guys. Well, it's been a dramatic week for the Cobbles. Anytime in the future?
Definitely, one day, yeah, sure. I mean, I'm not necessarily very good at planning my life any further than that 2 weeks ahead of what I'm doing right now. My organisation skills aren't that strong. I kind of just go wherever I feel like I need to be, and right now I'm having real good fun what I'm doing, so I hope that I can just do it justice, whatever I do now.
Pretty dark storyline for you. How do you combat that in terms of getting some light relief in your real life? How do you deal with it? Does it get to you?
To be honest with you, half an hour drive home, got a few tunes on the radio, and I just get on with it, really. Yeah. Got a great team around us, everyone's there supportive, and we do got some dark places with it. But, you know, you just switch off, really. You have to do it as soap. I think if you're doing a film or a one-off drama, you can just let it, you lose your mind for 2 or 3 weeks. With something like this, it goes on for such a long time, you've got to be able to just switch off and then get on with your life.
Marnie is one of Milan's newest fashion houses with a massive celebrity fan base. It's not that often that the worlds of fashion and GAA collide, and that's exactly what happened at Littlewood's latest shoot, and we went along to check it out. GAA stars Anthony Nash, Kieran Joyce and Austin Gleeson might be known for their slick moves on the pitch, but off the pitch it's all about their slick style. Some of these hurling legends consider themselves the new style icons?
Depends who you ask, I suppose. If that's my partner, she said no. I suppose if that's my mother, she says yes, unbelievable style, so depends. I suppose my style has changed a bit. I was with flash cutters back in the day, but you kind of grow out of that now, so I'm a little bit more neutral.
I suppose since I started with Littlewoods, I suppose I had to come. The style games had to open as well, but it wasn't the greatest on 17-18, but the last few years I had to pick up, so.
And when it comes to their everyday style, who are the fashionable gents that these GAA legends look up to?
Probably have to say Beckham. He's just kind of cool and kind of laid back. McGregor is totally mad in style, so I can't see myself in that.
I was going to a wedding, probably Killian Murphy, like Peaky Blinders. But that seems to be a look at the moment. But I know Niall Horan's cool look as well. But I suppose I'm gone to the age now where I can't really pull away Niall Horan looks anymore.
As a United fan, I suppose Beckham. He was a hero in growing up and stuff. So.
For the latest men's Be My Berry collection, head over to littlewoods.ie.
Yes, Linda, we're back just in the can of Ireland. No big deal. I hope it's going well for you in the studio there. It's lovely here. Sorry you couldn't join us. Anyway, I'm still joined by Rob. Rob, we've got another look for this amazing giveaway.
Years in the business. Congratulations to you. I'm a big fan of your work. And of course, everywhere I go, you know, it's one of those designs. You go, that's an Orla Kylie. And talk us through the 20 years. How happy are you to look back and go, wow, I've made it through and I'm this successful, I suppose?
Oh, do you know, it's funny, you don't always get the chance to look back, and
yeah.
we've just opened an exhibition in London, and so the build up for that was absolutely looking back on our 20 years. It was interesting. It's lovely to kind of have that chance.
The Orla Kylie print has become synonymous with fashion. Why do you think that has happened? Why do you think your prints have been so recognisable and done so well?
I don't know. It's always very hard to kind of gauge things like that. But there's a simplicity somehow, but there's also
and people find them uplifting. So I guess if they make you kind of smile or if they make you feel good, then yeah, people seem to enjoy them.
And where did your love of print come from, do you think?
I always loved print, from being a very little girl to having, you know, brown flowery wallpaper in my very 1970s bedroom. It was really when I went to the NCAD here in Dublin as a student where I kind of was able to develop it properly.
And the stamp print, why do you think that did so well?
I don't know, there's lots of reasons, but for somehow it seems to resonate.
You don't question it because it's done well. It's like, okay, that works.
And you know, all these things are kind of, you don't always have words to explain why.
Well, I know, Orla, if I'm walking down the street or walking in London or in Dublin, wherever, and I see a woman, I spot an Orla Collie bag, and I'm not you, so I can imagine when you're around, kind of, you see the passion. How does that make you feel?
That's lovely. I mean, I think if buying and using one of our bags makes people feel good, I think that's great.
Yeah. For more on the Orla Collie collection, check out kilkennyshop.com.
Competition time again. Here's your last chance to win with us tonight.
Best of luck.
That's it from us here, but before we go, let's head back to Kathy and Dorky.
Thanks, Glenda. Myself and Rob are off to get an ice cream. Rob, do you take a flake in yours?
Depends as offered.
Good enough answer for me. We're going to leave you with a look at what's to come on tonight's episode of Love Island.
There's romance. And some big news in the village.
Islanders, tonight there will be recoupling.
Oh.
The boy will choose and the girl not picked to be in a couple will be dumped from the island.
Oh.